Alright, welcome back, Wildcats. Another short video from Mrs. Bell's Wildcat Math Class. Still working on this review.
Still.
Down number 200 is number 11.
Did you make this?
Don't forget to subscribe if you like the videos. Alright, number 11. Determine the x-coordinate of the solution to the system. Okay, so the goal of this video is going to get 317 likes.
317 likes.
On this one video.
On this video.
Alright.
Gotta make it happen. Or 317 views.
No, likes.
Likes.
Only likes.
Yeah, it's easier. It's no more. Okay, here we go.
Or 92 likes.
Alright, so it wants to find the x-coordinate. So we could use substitution. We know that's equal to x, so I'm going to plug it in up there. So I have 3 times 22 minus 3y minus 4y is equal to negative 25.
Distribute.
66 minus 9y minus 4y. So we can, I'll combine those two, subtract the 66 over. So I got negative 13y is equal to negative 91. And divide by negative 13. So y is equal to 7. And unfortunately, they don't want y, they want x. So we'll plug that back up in. So we know that x is going to be equal to 22 minus 3 times 7. Or x is going to be equal to 22 minus 21. X is equal to 1.
I hate this problem.
So there's our final answer.
Do all that work, you get one.
It's not very satisfying to get one, is it?
Yeah.
Well, you could have guessed that on the chem test.
All right. Number 12. Questions on 11. Number 12. Determine the y-coordinate. Alright, so here we want to find the y, so what we want to do is eliminate the x.
Okay.
That make sense?
Yeah.
But then we don't have to do extra work. So let's multiply the top one by positive 4. So we'll end up with, we're going to write it down here, we'll end up with 4x minus 24y is equal to negative 124. Now if I combine these two equations, my x's get eliminated. So I got negative 27y is equal to negative 135.
Yes.
So if I divide by negative 27, y is equal to 5. Okay. Number 13, how many solutions does this system have? Okay. They're both linear, so if you get both equations in slope-intercept form, you can tell if they're parallel, same line, or if they have different slopes, they're always going to have one solution. So the first one is just y equals 5x minus 1, and the second one is 10x minus 2y is equal to 5. I want to get this in slope-intercept form, so I'll minus the 10x over. So I get negative 2y is equal to negative 10x plus 5, and divide everything by negative 2. So y is equal to 5x plus 5 halves. So they have the same slope. Oh, minus, thank you. They have the same slope, but they have different y-intercepts. So what can we say about those two lines?
Parallel.
They're parallel. So how many times will they touch?
Zero.
So zero solutions. All right, number 14. All right, same thing. And we got 5x minus 1 equals 1. So we'll subtract the 5x over. Negative y is equal to negative 5x plus 1. And we'll divide everything by negative 1. So y is equal to 5x minus 1. So what do we got? Infinite solutions, right? So it wouldn't be all solutions. Infinite. It'd be every point on the line. So infinite number of solutions. But a point over here would not be one of the solutions.
Okay.
You follow me?
Yeah.
All right, number 15.
Hello? Hello?
We're given f of x is equal to 4x squared minus 2, and g of x is equal to 3x plus 4. So number 15 wants us to find f of negative 2. So we're just going to take the negative 2, and we're going to plug it into the f function, wherever the x's are. So it's just going to be equal to 4 times negative 2 squared minus 2. 4 times 4, 16 minus 2 is equal to 14. So f of negative 2 is equal to 14. Any questions 11 through 15? Remember on this video, we're looking for 317 likes.
Comment Jerry down below.
317.
All right.
Carry down below.